And now we move on to exercise 4A, just the first exercise of chapter 4, using the Getting to Know ArcGIS Desktop book, updated for ArcGIS 9.3. The difference with exercise in chapter 4 is the introduction to ArcCatalog and to geodatabases. So this time, instead of opening ArcMap, we will be working with ArcCatalog, which is a somewhat different sub-program of ArcMap. So go ahead and click on ArcCatalog in your program menu. As you see, you immediately see a few differences. The first is that there's no map, there's no visual information. On the left-hand side, you have your geodatabases, your information, and on the right, we have three tabs: contents, preview, and metadata. Once you selected information in ArcCatalog, you can work in the right-hand screen. But first, we need to make a connection to your data. To do that, you simply click on Connect to Folder, surf to where your data is. For me, that's on that's a little bit complicated. There you go. So select the Getting to Know ArcGIS folder. Don't select any specific chapter, but just select the Getting to Know ArcGIS folder and click OK. What you see now is a direct connection to the ArcGIS data. We'll be using Chapter 4 data, so go ahead and go look at that. You'll see immediately what looks like different types of files. This file, or icon, which has the extension MDB, is a database. Each database is filled with different feature classes. The others are layers themselves. One is a layer, and one is a shape file. First, we're looking at the databases. The databases for the world is divided into four. As you see, there are four different features. For example, if you want to look at city, you can preview it, and you'll see the points which you've seen before in Chapter 3 on the cities of Amelia Earhart. Countries, the countries that Amelia Earhart visited. To create a thumbnail, I've already created a thumbnail for this one, so I'll show you how to make another thumbnail of a different feature. Let's look at the world. First, you click on preview. And then this is the create thumbnail. You'll see that I've created now a thumbnail of the disappeared areas. To do it for world, I do it for world. For city, and in this manner you can make thumbnails of all the of feature classes in a database. Now let's look at an individual feature. You can manipulate these visual areas just like an arc map. So you can zoom in. This is the same area in Papua New Guinea. If you want to know more about Papua New Guinea, again, you just use the identify tool and click. It turns green, and a window pops up with the information on Papua New Guinea. You can can return by clicking on Full Extent. And as shown in step 19 in your book, you not only can preview the visual data, but you can also visualize all the table data. In this instance, there are the countries of the world. So, different classes, area, square kilometers, the currency type, population, the name, etc. What type of file is this? These are polygons. There's a third tab. We've now seen the contents and the preview tab. Now we look at the metadata tab. Metadata is data about features or classes that we'll be using in a geodatabase. So the first tab is description about the data. So what is the data? The purpose of the data. You can also look at the status of the data, when it was published, information about the data, to access it, etc. Go ahead and click on different green sections, and it'll pop up the information that falls under that. There's two other tabs of metadata. We've now looked at the description. Spatial tab is about the coordinate system of the data that you'll be using. So, the coordinate system, spatial quality, different descriptions. For example, the feature type is a geographic polygon. A number of the polygons, there are 252. Lastly, is the attributes tab. So that's data on the data that you're looking at in the table. So, for example, population, country, data type, the width, definition. So it comes from the country, from the International Organization for Standardization. The source is the International Organization for Standardization. Currency type, where the data was coming from, etc. And that's it. That's the only thing you need to know. And this is a brief introduction to ArcCatalog. If you've completed now all of the steps, feel free to move on to exercise 4B.